Welcome back students. Here in access control and inheritance, in this case here, for example, class A is there. In class A, here I am going to declare three data members: public int A, private int B, protected int C. These three are the data members, right? A, B, C. These three are the data members. Now I am going to derive one more class, that is class B, from class A, right? Now class A is the superclass, class B is the subclass. Class A is the superclass, class B is the subclass. Here again public int X, private int Y, protected int Z, right? This class B is having three data members: X, Y, Z. X is present in public mode, Y is present in private mode, Z is present in protected access specifier. Here class A, three data members: A, B, C. Now here whenever we are going to derive a class from another class, now class B is going to derive from class A. Now class B is going to inherit all the properties of class A, all the data members, member functions of class A, except the private data members and member functions, right? This class B is going to inherit here public data member, that is A, and protected data member, that is C. That's it. Class B is not going to inherit the private data members of its superclass. Class B is not going to inherit the private data members of its superclass. This is the basic property. While we are going to performing inheritance, this is the basic property, that is subclass is not going to inherit the private properties of its superclass, right? Next slide. Here, see here, same class. This is the access specifier. Here same class, derived class, and outside the class. Here if same, here same class, this is the class A. In class A, here A is declared in public mode, B is declared in private mode, C is declared in protected mode. Now if I am going to create the object, if I am going to create the object for this class A obj, by using this object obj, I can access the variable A, I can access the variable B, I can access the variable C, right? By using this object of same class A, I can access the variable A, I can access the variable B, I can access the variable C. Same thing, public, protected, private, right? Here by using the object of the same class, we can access the public data members, we can access the protected data members, we can access the private data members. Now next one is the derived class. Now this class B is the derived class. Class B is the derived class. By using the object of class B, BObj2. Here obj2 is the object of class B. Obj2 is the object of class B. Now by using this one, by using this object, we can access the public data members and protected data members. We can access the public data members and protected data members. We can access the public data members and protected data members of its base class, right? By using the object of its derived class, by using the object of its derived class, we can access the public and protected data members of its base class, right? Third one is the outside the class. In outside the class, for example, here only private data members can access outside the class. There will be no question of private and protected. Here there is no question of private and protected variables. Here by using the object of another class, we can't access the private data members and protected data members outside the class. we can access only public data members of that particular class. This is the access specifier. Here if we are going to create the object for the same class, by using the object of the same class we can access the public, private and protected data members of the class. And if any derived class is there, by using the object of derived class we can access the public and protected data members of its super class. Next is the outside the class. In outside the class, public data members we can access anywhere, right? Next slide. And here derived class inherits all the base class functions, right? Derived class inherits all the base class functions except the constructors, destructors and copy constructors of the base class. See here, constructor is the A is the constructor, int A parameterized constructor, right? Here A obj, right? Now here constructors, parameterized constructor, copy constructor, destructors are not going to be inherited by its subclass. Copy constructor is not going to inherit, parameterized constructor is not going to inherit by its subclass, copy constructor is not going to inherit by its subclass, and destructor is not going to inherit by its subclass. Generally subclass is going to inherit all the properties, but whereas in this case it is not going to inherit the constructor, it is not going to inherit the parameterized constructor, it is not going to inherit the copy constructor, it is not going to inherit its destructor. Now next thing, overloaded operators of its base class. Here we can perform the operator overloading in its base class. If we are going to performing the operator overloading in its base class, that particular thing also not going to inherit by its subclass. Operator overloading also be not going to be inherited by its subclass. Here one more thing, friend function of the base class, friend void add is there, right? Friend void add functions are there. Here this type of functions are not going to inherit by its subclass or derived class. Here in general whenever we are going to use the inheritance concept, subclass is going to inherit all the properties of its base class, except that first one is the, it is not going to inherit the constructors, it is not going to inherit the copy constructor, parameterized constructor, destructors, and second one is the, it is not going to inherit the operator overloaded functions, and it is not going to inherit the friend functions of its base class. Modes of inheritance. There are three modes are there, right? See here, class B, public A. Here I am writing class B, public A. Here I am writing this thing now. Here, first one is the public mode. We can perform the inheritance in three modes. First one is the public mode, second one is the private mode, third one is the protected mode. First one is the public mode, second one is the private mode, third one is the protected mode. Here first one is the public mode. Here in public mode, see here, class A public int A void add, protected int B void sub, private int C void multiplication, right? Here in class A, I am declaring int A is the variable, where A is in public mode, B is in the protected mode, C is in the private mode, right? Here add function is there, add function is present in public mode, sub function is present in protected mode, multiplication is present in private mode. Here when deriving a class from a public base class, here I am deriving one class, class B. In which mode I am going to derive this class B? In public mode. Public, what is class name? A. Class name is A. Now here public int x, private int y, protected int z. Protected int z. Here I am deriving one class, that is class B, in public mode. In public mode I am deriving this class B. For this class B is the subclass for class A. Class A is the superclass for class B. Now public members of the its base class, public members, what are the public members here? Int A and white B, white add. Public members are the here, public members of the base class become public members of its derived class. Here what are the public members here? Int A and void add is there, na? Those are becomes the public members of class B. Int A, void add. Int A, void add are become the public members of class B. Class B is the derived class of class A. It is going to inherit all the properties of its class A, its super class. Now class A is the super class. Whatever the properties are present in class A is going to inherit by class B. If I am going to inheriting the class B in public mode, all the public members of its super class, what are the public members of its super class? A and add. These two are the public members of the base class, becomes the public members of its derived class. Now class B public members are int x, int A, void add. Int x, int A, void add. These three are the public members of its class B. Now protected members of the base class becomes the protected members of its derived class. Now what are the protected members of its base class? Int B and void sub. These two are the protected members, na? So here int B, void sub. Int B, void sub. Here these two are the protected members of its derived class. Now whatever the data members which are present in the public mode is going to be turned into the public mode members of its derived class. Whatever the data members, member functions of its protected int B and void sub, is these two are the, becomes the protected members of its subclass. And here this is the derived class B is not going to inherit the private data members of its superclass. Private data members of its superclass. Here, see, here C is there, void multiplication function is there. Now directly we can't use these private members outside the class by using the object of class B. See here, for example, class B is there, but you here I am creating the object by using the object 1 I can access A, by using the object 1 I can access add, by using the object 1 I can access B, by using the object 1 I can access sub function, right? If here B is the object 1, obj1 is the object for class B. OBJ1 is the object 1 object for class B. By using the object of class B, I can access the data members A, add, B and sub. Directly I can access. Here if I am going to deriving the derived class in public mode, and we can't directly access this C and multiplication function. These C and multiplication function, these two are the private data members of its superclass. C and multiplication, these two are the functions, these two are the private data members of the superclass A. To access the private data members of its superclass, we have to use public data members of its subclass. Here for example, here void display by using this void display function. This display function is present in class B, right? Class B is the subclass. By using the public member functions of subclass, we can access the private data members of its superclass. Before going to conclude this, again I will repeat this one. Here, whenever we are going to perform the inheritance in public mode, all the public data members and protected data members of its superclass becomes the public data members of its child class, as well as protected data members of its subclass, that is B. Now, directly we can't access the private data members of its superclass. To access the private data members of superclass, we have to use the member function which is present in the public mode of its subclass. By using the member function which is declared in public mode of subclass, we can access the private data members of its superclass, right? Next one, protected mode. Here, whenever we are going to deriving any class in protected mode, see here, same thing. Class instead of public, here I am going to write protected mode, protected A. Here, when deriving a class from protected base class, public and protected data members of base class becomes the protected data members of its derived class. Here, what are the public data members? Int A, and protected data members int B, and void sub void add. Here, this is the superclass, this is the subclass. Now, I am deriving this class B in protected manner. Here, I am performing the inheritance from in between A and B, here by using the protected access specifier model. In this case, whenever we are deriving a subclass in the protected access specifier mode, here, what are the public data members and protected data members are present in its superclass are become the protected data members of the subclass here. Now, what are the protected data members of this class B? Int A, int B, void add, void sub. See here, what are the data members present in public mode in superclass becomes the protected data members. What are the data members member functions which are present in the protected mode becomes the protected data members. In this example, class B is a subclass, class A is a superclass. I am inheriting the class B in protected manner. Now, public and protected data members becomes the protected data members of its subclass. Now, whenever we are going to create the object for class B, we can call this A, B, void add and sub. And here, we can't access the private data members of class A. We can't access the private data members of its superclass if we are going to performing the inheritance in protected manner, right? Third case, here private mode. When deriving from a private base class, public and protected members of the base class becomes the private members of the derived class. See here, protected manner, here I am going to deriving the class B in private, mode. Class B is the subclass, class A is the superclass, private is there, access specifier is private. Now, here I am going to deriving the subclass in private access specifier mode. In that case, what are the public data members, protected data members of its base class? Public data members, what are the public data members? Int A and void add. What are the protected data members? Int B and void sub, right? These are going to become the private data members of its subclass. Now, what are the private data members here? Now, int A, void add, int B, void sum. Right? Now, public and protected data members of the superclass becomes the private data members of its subclass whenever we are going to performing the inheritance in private access specifier mode. You see here, there are three phases are there: public mode, private mode and protected mode. In public mode, public and protected data members of its superclass becomes the public and protected data members of its subclass. Here directly we can't access the private data members of its base class. By using the public functions of its derived class, we can access the private data members of its superclass. Second mode is the protected mode. Whenever we are going to performing the inheritance in protected mode, here public and protected data members member functions of superclass becomes the protected data members of its derived class, whereas in case of private mode, here public and protected data members are going to become the private data members of its derived class. Here in these two cases, we can't access the private data members of its superclass by using the object of subclass. In next class, I'm going to explain the inheritance with an example. Thank you.